Hey guys, Sean Nalawani here of seannal.com and bodytransformationtruth.com. And in this video, I want to answer the question of what happens when you stop taking creatine. So will you lose all of the positive benefits that you achieved during creatine supplementation? And are there any possible side effects associated with suddenly discontinuing creatine use? So let's go over it. The first thing to keep in mind here is that everybody responds to creatine supplementation differently. Some lifters see significant gains from it, while others as high as up to 30% of the population are known as creatine non-responders, and they don't see any noticeable results whatsoever. The effects that you personally experience once you discontinue creatine supplementation are largely going to depend on how well you responded to it in the first place. So the more significantly you responded, the more noticeable the change will be once you stop, and vice versa. Creatine benefits your muscle building program in two major ways. The first is by increasing intracellular water retention, and the second is by increasing your strength and power in the gym. So let's take a look at each of these two factors. The first are the changes in intracellular water retention. So creatine requires additional water in order to be stored in your muscle tissue. And after your muscles have become completely saturated with creatine, and this usually happens around about 3 weeks after supplementing with 5 grams daily, your muscles should take on a slightly fuller appearance as a result of the increased fluid. So once you discontinue creatine supplementation and those extra creatine stores have left your body after a few weeks, this additional water retention will no longer be necessary and will be cleared out as well. For some lifters, this might mean a fairly quick drop of several pounds of water weight once the creatine levels leave their system. And for others, the effects may hardly even be noticeable. Again, this really depends on how well you responded at the very start. One thing is for sure though, and that is that whatever additional water weight you gained from your creatine supplementation when you began will mostly be lost once you discontinue. And the second issue are the changes in strength and power. Now, this is much harder to accurately pinpoint. And again, it's going to vary quite a bit from person to person. By increasing the efficiency of your body's use of ATP, which is the usable energy molecule within your muscles, creatine improves your gym performance and increases your overall strength and power output. Now, when you stop using creatine, the additional phosphate groups it was previously providing to your muscle cells for enhanced strength will also be diminished. So, assuming that you are someone who does respond well to creatine supplementation, you may notice a small reduction in your overall strength after a few weeks of stopping. However, it likely won't be to a very significant degree as long as you continue with your regular training program. As far as your actual lean muscle gains are concerned, it's highly unlikely that you're going to notice any real decrease there. Again, assuming that you continue with your training and eating plan in the same way as you were previously. Now, are there any side effects to suddenly stopping creatine use? Well, creatine is the most widely researched sports supplement in the world, and it's never been shown to be harmful in any way when used within the recommended daily dosage of about 5 grams. And this includes periods of cycling on and off. Your body does adjust its own natural production of creatine in response to external supplementation, but this system is extremely sensitive and it adapts virtually instantly. So once you stop taking creatine, your natural production will fall back into the proper range. The real question here though is why stop at all? Sure, if you don't see any real results from using creatine in the first place, then obviously there's no need for you to continue. Or perhaps you're just tired of having to worry about taking it every day. Maybe you really dislike the taste or the texture, though in that case you could just use creatine pills. Or maybe you're traveling and you don't want to take it with you everywhere you go. In those cases, the choice is yours. But assuming that you've been using creatine consistently and you have seen positive benefits, I can't see any real good reason to stop. First off, as I covered in detail in a previous video, which I'll link here as well as in the description box below, there's really no benefit at all to cycling on and off of creatine. For optimal creatine results, you should simply continue with a 5 gram per day dosage on an ongoing basis. Secondly, there's no evidence to suggest that continual creatine supplementation over the long term is dangerous to your health in any way. And thirdly, creatine is very inexpensive, and if you purchase it in bulk, it's really only going to cost you somewhere around 2 cents per gram, which on a monthly basis works out to about $3. And if cost really is an issue, keep in mind that most people can probably get away with as little as 3 grams of creatine daily, in which case it drops to about $2 a month. So to wrap this all up, if you've been supplementing with creatine to the point of full saturation and then you decide to discontinue, this is what's going to happen after a few weeks. Number one, you will lose the additional water retention that your body was using to store the creatine. Number two, you may notice a slight reduction in your overall strength levels, but likely not to a significant degree. Number three, you will likely retain all of your gains in actual lean muscle mass. And number four, you're not going to experience any unfavorable side effects. Once again, though, this all depends on the individual and on how well they responded to the creatine in the first place. If you're considering stopping creatine use, but you're not quite sure, your best bet is to simply discontinue for 2 to 3 weeks and then see what happens. If you do experience a drop in your overall muscle fullness and your strength that you aren't happy with, then you can always go right back on. Or if you don't notice any real changes at all, then of course you can just stop altogether. So thanks for watching this video lesson. I hope you found the information useful here today. If you did enjoy the video, as always, please make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos. Also, make sure to check out my complete step-by-step muscle building and fat loss programs over at bodytransformationtruth.com. The link for that is in the description box below. And make sure to join the Facebook page for daily tips and updates. The link for that is also in the description box. Talk to you again soon.